We're going to code a scenario using ICD-10-CM. In this scenario, you're going to learn how to use the neoplasm table. First, I'm going to start by reading the scenario. This 50-year-old female was diagnosed with left breast carcinoma 4 years ago, at which time she had a left mastectomy performed with chemotherapy administration. She has been well since that time with no further treatment except for yearly checkups. The patient is now being seen with visual disturbances, dizziness, headaches, and blurred vision. Workup was completed, which revealed metastases to the brain, accounting for these symptoms. This was identified as being metastatic from the breast, not a new primary. What diagnosis codes are assigned? In this case, the breast cancer was previously excised with no further treatment directed at that site. So we're going to code that a little later as history of breast cancer. This time, we're looking at the metastatic cancer to the brain. So I'm going to begin by going to the neoplasm table. It's right after your alphabetical index. I am going to look for brain. The neoplasm table lists all of the body parts in alphabetical order. So I'm going to go down alphabetically and find brain. And remember, there's subheadings under a lot of these body parts, so don't stop looking too soon and think you haven't found brain. And I found brain NEC. And now this is a metastatic cancer. It is not the primary. The first column is for malignant primary. The second column is malignant secondary. Cancer in situ, benign, uncertain, or unspecified behavior. We're going to use the malignant secondary column. So the code for brain NEC is C79.31. So now I'm going to turn to the tabular list and verify that code. I'm going to turn to the C section and look up 79.31. And I found the code. It's secondary malignant neoplasm of the brain. And that is correct for a metastatic cancer. So that's my first code. That's my principal diagnosis. Now I'm going to look at the scenario and figure out what else I need to code. Remember that I mentioned that the breast cancer had been excised previously, and so we're going to code that as history of breast cancer. So I'm going to go back to my alphabetical index, and I'm going to look up the word history. Notice when I first find this section of the code book, initially I see family history, directly under history. So I need to make sure that I go down further and find personal history. And I found that right here. So now I'm going to look for malignant neoplasm, which is generally how we refer to cancer when we're coding. I found it right here, and I go down and I find breast, and the code is Z85.3. So now again, I want to go to the tabular list and I want to verify that code. Near the end of the code book, Z85.3. And I found the code. Z85.3 is personal history of malignant neoplasm of the breast. So is there anything else that I want to code? Let's take a look at the scenario again. The patient had a mastectomy and also had a personal history of chemotherapy. Since those are related to this metastatic cancer, we want to code those as well. So I'm going to look up the mastectomy, and that is absence of a body part. So I'm going to go back to the alphabetical index, and I'm going to look up absent. It takes a little practice to get familiar with what terms to look up in the alphabetical index, and it's really important to learn what to look up, what terms to use to look up a code in the alphabetical index before you try using an encoder. An encoder is a computerized way of looking up a code, and it can lead you down the wrong path if you don't know what terms are used in the code book. So I'm going to look up absent. And I found absence. And I want to find the body part of breast. And I found it right down here. Z90.1, and then there's a dash with a check mark. That means I need an additional character in this code. The code is not complete if I just use the Z90.1. So I'm going to go back to the alphabetical or the tabular list, and I'm going to look up Z90. Z90.1, acquired absence of breast and nipple, and I look down in the subterms under that, and I find that there's one specifically for the left breast. A lot of codes in ICD-10 have right, left, and bilateral characters. So my final code is Z90.12. I also want to code the history of chemotherapy for the neoplasm. So I go back to the alphabetical index and I look up history again. History, and I make sure I'm at the section with the personal history, not family history. And I find chemotherapy. And here's the code, chemotherapy for neoplastic condition, Z92.21. So this scenario has four codes. I want to also verify this in the tabular list by going to Z92. .21, and the complete code description is personal history of anti-neoplastic chemotherapy. So that's the correct code. It's a complete code. There's no little red check mark next to it showing that I need additional characters. There's no additional notes related to this code that I need to pay attention to. So I have my four codes, and they are Z79.31 as a principal diagnosis, and then as other diagnoses, Z85.3, Z90.12, Z92.21. And that completes the coding of this scenario.